That's the way. Every day you can play Beat the Clock. And now here's the star of the all-new Beat the Clock, Monty Hall.
Thank you very much. Thank you and welcome to Beat the Clock. Well, the whole world is waiting with bated breath to see whether Ron and Gloria Aitman can finally do that lariat trick in the bonus stunt if they get that far. And what happens on Beat the Clock is couples play against each other and against our famous clock for lots of money. And when we get to that bonus stunt, it could be worth an awful lot of money. So stick around and watch this show and enjoy the stunts, too. Who are the couples today, Jack?
Well, Monty, our returning champions, as you know, are Ron and Gloria Aitman. So far, they've won $5,600. Here to challenge them, however, we have Michael Olson and Josie Albello.
Hey, Josie. So that's the tall and short of it, huh? I sort of have a feeling that in this relationship, she wields the upper hand.
Yes, she does.
You've got to watch out for those little ones, right, Mike?
Yeah. Little ones are really tough.
Right. Small packages, but dynamite. What do you do, Mike?
I'm a waiter and a songwriter. I'm going to keep waiting tables till I sell a song, I guess.
Yeah,
it's a tough business.
I wish we had the kind of a show where we could just sit back and listen to some of the songs you've written.
Well, that's all right, you know. Maybe but, some other time.
But if you do well, that'll be the next stunt on the next show, right? Okay. And Josie, while he's waiting on tables, ready to write that famous Stardust song?
I'm a switchboard operator waiting to sing my first hit.
Oh, I see. It's one of those things, huh? Well, what you ought to do is audition. You know, instead of saying Mr. So-and-so's office or something like that, you should sing it. Do you ever try that?
Gee, I'll give it a try. I don't know about the guys at work, what they'll say about that.
Who cares what they say about that? Say Monty told you. And Ron and Gloria, here they are, the Aitmans. Picked up a few thousand bucks, right?
Yes, yes.
How much is it now?
$5,600.
$5,600, very good. And, of course, just die to win again today and play that lariat thing. Well, maybe you will. At any rate, we're going to go off and start off head and head. And in our very first stunt for today, we're going to use both the men and the ladies. So if you'll come with me, we'll see these two great big racks full of balloons. And I want you to please note that these balloons are all at the top part of these carts. And the reason for that is they're helium-filled, and if they ever escape, they're just gone, as you can imagine. Now, what we're going to do is have you two gentlemen come over here, lie face down, facing the camera. Face down, facing the camera on our magic carpets. At any given word for me, you know, any given word, I just say, they're in a way, go the carpets, and we never see you again. Now, you just lie there like good fellas while I tell the girls what they're going to do. When I say go, you will take these balloons one at a time from out here and place them under their body somehow so they can trap them. The idea is for the gentlemen to trap as many balloons as they can and keep them trapped and see how many they have by 60 seconds. The one who has trapped the most balloons under his body or any part of his body, of course, is going to be the winner. If a balloon escapes, that's just too bad. It depends on how you put them underneath there. All right? One at a time, girls. If you're ready, go. Oh, she's trying off with a harness, isn't she? Boy, that poor fellow's got to stay up there in that position a long time. One would have thought she might have started with the arms and legs. But she's got the green team gun right under his tummy. Where Ron, on the other hand, he's relaxing because they'll have to work with his tummy last, I guess. Well, I think I better get off the firing line. We have judges who are counting these. Man, a green team just escaped. That's a tough fight. I should also remind everybody that it's the amount of balloons that are still inflated that count. Don't broken balloons count. Remember, fellas, broken balloons don't count. We still have 5 seconds. Our judges are counting. That's all. Oh, he just lifted up here and three escape. 13 here. And only 6 left here. Ron, you're laughing over there. Ron, you can do anything you want, fellas, because when you get up now, you watch what happens to the balloons. The green team wins by $100. Everybody back to home. I want to tell you, Michael and Josie, I really didn't think you were going to win. I'll tell you why. because, you know, that's a very tough position down there. And what you should really have started is the way they did, putting it under arms and legs, and then at the end let him come up and try and get him under the belly. You started him that way, and Michael, you were there from the very beginning like that. That's a tough position, I'll tell you. However, you did come through, and you won your first $500. It goes up on the board. Now, you're going to get a chance to play another game, just the two of you against the clock, for an additional $500. And for this one, what have we got? Oh, I love this one. This is cute. Great one. You'll get to know each other quite well on this one. Come over here. Gentlemen, will sit down. Sit down on the chair facing out that way. Would you, Michael? Michael sits. Oh, you sit too, but the way you're going to sit is going to be a little different, because you're going to sit... You're going to sit on his lap, sideways. That's it. Make room for her to sit down. Make it nice and comfortable for her, will you? Now, grasp her around the waist. Josie, put your arms around his head and clasp your hands together. That's it. And in that position of clasped hands, don't let go for anything. That's kind of nice to come on a show and they... It's not that kissing. It's kind of cute, but isn't going to get you anywhere. What you're going to try and do now is get an additional $500. I'm going to place this derby hat at your feet. Would you take your shoes off for me, Josie? Can you slip them off easily? Good. Good. What I'm going to ask you to do now, I'm going to place the derby hat at your feet, and using your feet alone, you'll have to pick it up and put it on his head, just like that. And if you can do that, you'll get another $500. How much time? What, dear? Sure, you can roll up your pants while we look at the clock to see how much time we have for this stunt. You're going to have to do this in 50 seconds. Okay, dear? Always with the hands clasped in that position. Okay. Would you mind? I want to put the derby hat down. Ready? Go. Sure, you use both your feet. Keep your hands clasped. Keep your hands clasped. All right, I'm coming right back. Here we go, here we go. You have 15 seconds. You still have 10 seconds. Yeah, 5 seconds. I just can't get it on there myself. Oh, nice try. How about a nice hand for these kids? Now, you'll have to admit this. Even though you didn't get the 500, you sure get to know each other in a stunt like that, don't you? All right, green team, as we go into the commercial break, have 500. The red team have nothing. More money to be given away. More stunts coming up right after this. Okay. What we have here are two bowls filled with straws, ordinary drinking straws, but we've slid the paper part partially down the straw, because you know the way that game plays when you were kids. You used to go and just whoosh, throw that paper all over the place. You're going to have a chance to play that kids game right now. But what you're going to do is blow those straws, ladies, up against the flypaper that we have here. And if you make the little paper part over here stick to it, why, of course, you're going to win yourself some money. Now, this is a race. It's a 60-second race, and the one who gets most paper on the flypaper in 60 seconds will be the winner. All right, just lift up and blow when I say go, when I say go. Go. Ah, there's one for the red team. And And did she get it on the end in time? All right, hold it. Hold it, girls. Don't go away. It's 3-3. We're going to sudden death. No? One of hers is hers? Yeah, but if it ends up here, who does it belong to? Nobody? So, huh? We need a decision from the judges. All right. Our judges say that if she didn't blow it on, she doesn't get credit for it. So it's 3-2. The red team wins. One thing about me, folks, I got a lot of courage. I let the other guy make the decision. And the judges say you had to blow it on. That was what I said going in. And the one who blows it on, you didn't blow it on. And so you only got credit for 2. The red team had 3 and gets their first $500. Take a look on the scoreboard. You're both tied with $500. And now it comes time for the red team to play an extra game for an additional $500. So come out with me, Aitmans, and we'll go right out to center stage. This will be kind of interesting. We're going to have you, Gloria, we're going to have you standing on this mat right over here. And there we have what we call a goal. It's a goal, but it has a little fence in front of it. And what we want you to do, and with the assistance of Ron, is to knock these beach balls into this little goal here. And we're going to ask you to put 2 of them inside the goal in this amount of time on the clock. Let's take a look at the clock. How much time do we have for this stuff? 45 seconds. But there's an interesting wrinkle about how you're going to do it. See, Ron, you're going to stand over here where Cindy is standing right now. Right here. Come over here and take the beach balls. One at a time, she'll hand them to you. You will throw them over to Gloria. Gloria's going to put her hands behind her head. And standing sideways to the net, she's going to give it a little boom-dee-doo here and get it inside there. And it has to go in the air, so don't try and bounce it. Okay. Now, here's the trick, Ron. You're going to have to throw it in such a position that Gloria will be ready to go whoopsie-doo and knock it into that goal, okay? Are you ready? Go. Little lower down, little lower down. Little lower down. What I have to do is call back that girl who was doing the stunts for us in rehearsal. She had some real great action. I mean, she put them right over the fence there. But I'm sorry, you don't get the additional $500. So at the end of all these stunts so far today, each team in the cash department has $500. But the all-important bonus shuffle game that determines the champion is coming up right after these messages. Shuffleboard is divided into money amounts that range from $300 all the way up to $1,000. And the team whose disc is touching the highest amount of money and leading at that time will be the winner, collect that amount of dough, and then play that bonus game for 10 times that amount. And Gloria and Ron know what I'm talking about because they've tried that one 4 times now and are hoping for a 5th time. Caution. If you take that disc and try for a high amount, you may go flying off the end of the board, in which case the disc is out of play. If you have a wild throw and is off the side or is knocked off the side, it's out of play. And if you don't go far enough to touch the first money amount, I will remove the disc from the board. Now, because we have a tie, each team will have 2 discs to throw. No advantage there. The champions, though, do get last throw. Girls go first. Josie will be followed by Gloria. And then Michael, and then Ron. Josie, take your time, and when you're ready, you can move it away from there. That's right. Whenever you're ready, take a shot. That looks like a good shot. Yes, it's all the way up and touching $800. All right, so Green's had good position. Now Gloria will take her first shot and try to dislodge it, I'm sure. But she missed it, and she went off the board. Which puts the green team in a very good position right now because they have 1, and Michael will probably try to put a block on there. so that Ron won't be able to get it. Here goes Michael's shot. And, well, now he's got two on, but he's left Ron in a position where, with a great shot, he could probably dislodge him or even pass him by. Here's the last shot of the day. Ron shoots. And the green team is the winner. Ronnie, I want you to see something, Ron. As you notice, you had two greens to dislodge. You threw a perfect shot. If it had just been a little harder, you still would have been here, and this one would have gone off the board. It was a very well-calculated shot. Too bad, though. It didn't work, and so we have a new champion, the green team. That's Michael and Josie, and they get $900 on the board. That brings their day's total up to $1,400. And more important than that, the green team will be playing that bonus nut that you wanted to play so badly in just a few moments for $9,000. Okay, folks, this is what we've been waiting for, the bonus nut and a possible $9,000 for Michael and Josie. What a moment this is. Now, Michael, you've been watching this being played, so let's take the hoop right up here with the lariat at the other end and get the rope where you want it, okay? Pull it right through. That's it. Now, what you're going to do is hold it at one end and throw the hoop with the other hand. Now, do you know what you like to do with right-handed, right? So you'll hold the hoop.
I think I'm going to throw it.
That's right. Fine. That is right-handed, Michael, in case you're worrying about it, right? Now, what he's going to try and do, Josie, he's going to try, and not leaving the mat, try and rope this bowling pin and slowly bring it back to himself without making it fall down. It has to come back in that same upright position, Michael, and to a place, hold it dear, to a place where you can reach forward and get the bowling pin and hand it to me. Do it twice. You've got to do it with two pins. The amount of time for the stunt is on the clock right now. They have to do it in 45 seconds. All right, now Josie, you replace the pin every time it falls down. Are you ready? Go. Oh, that bounced right over. That one in, there wasn't enough time on the clock. And incidentally, that is the fifth time we played this bonus stunt, which means we retire it. When the Aitmans are delighted. The Aitmans are delighted we're retiring it. No, we figure it this way, that once a stunt has beaten our contestants, we put it away to pasture and we bring it back another day. Although I must say that in rehearsal, and even Ron managed to get one the last time out, I had 22 seconds left to get the second one, and he almost did it. So we'll say goodbye to this particular stunt, and we'll see what other bonus stunts we have in the future. In the meantime, we take a look at the score on the board, and it's $1,400 for the green team, $500 for the red team. Let's go back to home base, and while we're doing that, you fellas, watch these messages. Well, you know, folks, we informed our teams before the show this evening that that whatever happened to the winning team, they would be called champions for the day. But starting next week, we'll have a format with all celebrities, which means we say goodbye to all four players today, and they understand that. And not bad for Michael and Josie, because Michael Olson and Josie Albello picked up $1,400 on their stay here. Congratulations to you. Not bad for one day's work, right? That'll help. $1,400 and all that manuscript paper you have to buy, right? Ron and Gloria, of course, you were here a long time, and you added some more money today, $500 to your total. So during your stay on Beat the Clock, you picked up $6,100. And I congratulations to you as well. I hope you enjoyed it. Very good. I'm delighted. Well, we had a lot of fun with Ron and Gloria, especially playing that bonus stunt. And all the instructions they gave to you just didn't work out today, did it? All right, so it's bye-bye. And don't forget, when you tune in Monday, four celebrities playing Beat the Clock. Be sure to watch.